Welcome to Simply Excel. In today's video, I'm going to talk you through how to do some basic calculations on your data and also how to use some of the more common formulas available in Excel. To start with, I'm going to show you a couple of ways you can use add, subtract, divide and multiply. The first way I'm going to show you is simply typing your numbers in to your formula. So we start by coming to the cell we want to put our result in and pressing the equals sign. This tells Excel that we want to use a formula. We can then just go ahead and type our numbers in. For example, if we wanted to add 1 and 2, press return, and we've got our result of 3. The other way we can do this is by entering our numbers into our spreadsheet and then using our equals sign, clicking on our cells, and putting the plus sign in between our cell references rather than our manually typed numbers. Press return, and we've got our result of 3. We can use both these methods for all types of calculations. So for example, we can subtract 3 minus 2, and we get our 1. Again, we can do this by entering our numbers into our spreadsheet and using our cell references. Same applies for divide. So we can divide our 12 by 3. And to divide, we use the forward slash. And to multiply, 2 by 3. And we get a result of 6. So we can also mix these up. For example, if we just had one of our numbers in our spreadsheet, so if we have the 2 in here, we take the 3 out, and we say we'd like to multiply our 2 by 5. We can just manually enter the 5 in our formula, press return, and we get a result of 10. So that's how easy it is to just start doing some basic calculations on your data. Let's look at how we might apply those in the real world. So I've got my sales data here, and let's say we want to calculate our total order price from our units sold multiplied by unit price. So in our column here, we can say we want our total, and this is equals our units sold multiplied by our unit price. Press return, and that's calculated it for us. So now we've entered this formula, we can also copy it to other rows. We can do that by doing Control C and copy it to any row we like. You'll see that what it's done there is it's updated the cell references in the formula so that they apply to the row we're now in. Likewise, if we click in the bottom right hand corner and drag our formula down, it updates the reference in each row. And finally, if we want to copy that down our entire column, we just double click here in the bottom right hand corner. So let's move on to taking a look at some of the common formulas you might use day to day. The first one we're going to look at is AutoSum, and I think this is probably the most commonly used formula of all. To demonstrate how this works, if we come to the bottom of our total column by pressing Control and down arrow, we come to our next available blank cell, and we can either click on the AutoSum button over here or press Alt and equals on our keyboard. You'll see this has entered a formula called sum and defined the range for the data for that formula. So it's adding up everything from cell F2 down to the cell F649. So that's everything in our column that contains data. We confirm we're happy with this selection by pressing return, and we get our result of our total value of all our orders. So let's take a closer look at the sum function. Come back to our calculation sheet. I'm just going to use the numbers that I've typed in here to demonstrate how useful sum can be. So what sum allows you to do is sum up the values in a range of cells. So whereas before we were typing equals this number plus this number and so on, if we wanted to do a large range of data using that, you could see that would be quite laborious and prone to errors. So what the sum function allows us to do, when we type sum, we open our brackets, let it know that we're going to start inputting our data. We can literally highlight all the numbers that we want to add up. So we can add up this whole area, and you'll see the reference has now updated to B2, so that's the top left cell here, down to D5, which is our bottom right. Close our brackets, press return, and the sum of all our data in that table is 43. So that's really useful. We don't have to enter every single one of those cells into our formula. So that was really useful to be able to add up a whole block of data in one go. But it does also let you pick a few non-sequential and non-related cells. So for example, we could do something like put our sum function in, open our brackets, take the whole of this column, and then separating by commas, add in a few other cells, close our brackets, and it will just add the cells we selected then. We'll come back to our sales data tab to show you a couple more useful formulas. For example, if we wanted to find out the maximum units sold on any one order, we could come down to the bottom of our units sold column Scroll down to our next available cell. Type equals to start using a formula, and the formula we're going to use is max. Open our brackets. Select our entire column by pressing Ctrl, Shift and Up. Close our brackets. And it's returned the maximum number in that column, so it didn't matter that I included the header in that calculation. It's ignored that because it's not a number, and it's telling me that the maximum number of units sold on any one order is 25. Similarly, we can do minimum, and that's min. Again, select all our data, and press return, and our minimum order is one unit. Another useful one is average, so if we wanted to find our average unit price, exactly the same process, and that's giving you the arithmetic mean average. Formulas in Excel don't just work on numbers, they work on text as well. I'm going to show you how to use a formula called unique to get a unique list of regions from our sales data table. So as with any formula, we start by typing equals, then we type unique, open our brackets, and we specify our array of data, which in this case is going to be our region column. Now we don't want the word region to be included, so we're going to start on row 2 and press Ctrl, Shift and down to select our whole column. Close our brackets, press return, and we've got our list of regions. And the final thing I'm going to run through is how you nest multiple formulas together so we can carry out more than one action on our data in one go. So in this instance, you can see that our regions are not sorted alphabetically. So we're going to wrap our unique function in the sort function. So we come up to our formula bar, we type sort, open our brackets. You'll see that's now highlighted the brackets on the unique function in red, because it recognises those two are a pair that relate to each other. And then when we type our final bracket to close our sort function, we've also got that black pair of brackets as well. Press return, and our list's now neatly sorted alphabetically. I hope you found this introduction to calculations and formulas in Excel useful. Please give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more Excel tips, including some videos covering some more common formulas. Thanks for watching.